Ever wanted to inform your team about something that happened on your website? But in this video, I'm gonna show you our Slack webhook tag template that lets you send data directly from Google Tag Manager into a Slack channel. All or more, coming up. Hey there, Measure Geeks, Julian here, back with another video. Today, I want to introduce you to our new Slack webhook tag template that we have now in the community gallery of Google Tag Manager. This will let you send a Slack message directly to your channel of choosing with any data that you have gathered inside of Google Tag Manager. Where might this be useful? Well, if you have an error happening on your website or a conversion event and you want your team or your stakeholders or yourself to know about it, then this is a great way to monitor data in real time. Let me show you how we set this all up. So here we are in our Google Tag Manager account, and here is our tag that sets up a Google Analytics event when a 404 error happens. And I have already this trigger set up, and what data actually goes over to Google Analytics is simply an event with the page path. So where does the 404 error happen, and the referrer, so which page did the user just came from, so we can fix that link potentially or redirect the user to the right destination. Now, what if we wanted to send this into our Slack so our team gets informed? Well, we can set up this new tag template that I've developed. So we go here to tag configuration and then go to the community gallery. And when you search in this community gallery for Slack, you should find this template by Measure School, and you can add this to your workspace. You need to allow some permissions here to inject the script, which sends over that data and then also accesses the global variables. So let's go ahead and add this here. And then we are ready to roll. Now, really, all we need is our Slack webhook URL right here. Where do we get this? Well, we would create a custom Slack app. So inside of our Slack account, well, we can go over here to our workspace, and then under settings and administration, we can manage apps. And this will bring you over to your app menu. You can click up here on build, or if it's faster for you, you can just go over to api.slack.com. And then from here, you can create your new app. Now, you can give this app any name you want. If you have multiple alerts, we are just going to call this 404 error. So it's going to be our 404 error app. And then we add this to our test workspace here and create this app. Next, we choose our incoming webhooks. This is what we want to trigger when the app should become active. And we click on here for the webhooks. And now we create our webhooks down here by add new webhook to workspace. Then we need to choose our channel. I want to inform the whole team. So I'm going to go with the team channel here. And now in our Slack, we should already see here under team, I have just added our integration 404 error. And down here, we get our webhook URL. So we can copy this and simply go over to Google Tag Manager and put this in here. Now, what do we want to send over as a Slack message? We can really send anything here. In our case, it was the page that this 404 error happened. So let's go ahead and put in page here and then with variables. Unfortunately, in this window, the variable menu doesn't work. But as far as I remember, it's page path. And then we also have our referrer that we want to send over. These are built-in variables, so we should be able to pull them in this way. That is all we need. Obviously, we need to also put in our trigger. I have this prepared already. If you want to set this up, then check out our video on how to set up 404 error tracking with Google Analytics, where we create this trigger. And I'm going to give this a name. So this would be Slack. And we are sending over a message on our 404 error. Let's save this and try this out. Now I'm going to go to a page that doesn't exist here. Page could not be found. Our tag assistant shows us that our Slack message sent off, and in our Slack channel, we get a message from our 404 error app that this page doesn't exist, 404, and the referrer where the user just came from. So in our case, it was tagassistant.google.com. Now somebody in the team could go ahead and say, hey, we should fix that error, or we could ignore it, or put in a redirect maybe on our page in order to fix this. So pretty handy here, but you could name as your message anything you want. So if this would be a conversion, maybe you want to transfer something over about that conversion, the order ID, for example, or get informed about JavaScript errors and send them on to your developer, for example. You might have noticed that down here is a use advanced variable here. And for that, you will need to have a predefined Slack variable. What is this all about? Well, Slack actually gives you the ability to customize your messages even further. So you'll get something like right here, some building blocks that give you buttons or images, and you need to use the Blockkit builder for this. So they have a few templates here of messages and what they would look like. For example, here you have these buttons and so on. Obviously, this doesn't all work with our webhook because it's not really an interactive app, but I have found that for our 404 errors, it can be quite useful to have some dropdown menus. So you need to write this in JSON format. So there's a special kind of format that you need to input, just like this here. And it's Markdown and JSON. You can use the templates and customize them to your heart's content. I've come up with something right here, and it gives me a little bit of a dropdown menu so I can determine if this is fixed or needs fixing or ignore it if it's not relevant. So I can take my predefined JSON here, just copy this and go over to Google Tag Manager, and I would need to have a variable. Let's go ahead and create a custom JavaScript variable for our Slack message. And we choose custom JavaScript. Now, custom JavaScript always needs to have an anonymous function, which returns a value. And in our case, it should simply return our JSON object here. Let's save this and go ahead and implement this into our tag. So I'm going to get rid of this here and use instead the advanced variable with our JSON Slack message here. Let's save that and preview again. And as the page loads, we get now our menu that looks a bit more stylized. And we have our little drop-down menu here if this is fixed or it needs fixing or it's ignored. We get this little warning here that this is not an interactive response. So it doesn't really do anything. It just changes the field up here. But it's enough for my colleagues to see whether we should follow up on this or ignore it. All right, I hope you found this quite useful. For us, it was quite useful for the 404 errors. We are constantly fixing stuff on our website. But I can think of many other different circumstances where this would be useful if you want to be informed about a conversion that happened, or you could configure it that every time somebody comes from AdWords and then converts, send a Slack message to your client and he'd be quite happy to know that the campaign actually works. Or any kind of monitoring of things. Now, just remember, Slack is not a tracking app, so I wouldn't send copious amounts of data into the system, especially because you can't really download it and then analyze it as a normal tracking tool or analytics tool would do. But for certain use cases, it can be quite handy to know that something happened in your account and be notified of certain things. Now, I'd love to hear from you if you'd be using this and which circumstances. Let me know in the comments down below. Your use cases and others probably can benefit from this as well. Now again, you can set this up with many different triggers. For example, when a conversion happened, you just need to attach this tag to the right trigger. I have a video right over there which will show you how to set up a conversion trigger. And if you haven't yet, then you should definitely also subscribe to our channel right over there. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.